listening to Opie and Anthony. Opie and Anthony on the Virus.
XM. Hey, Brett Ratner in studio. Know, we're talking about the McRibs real fast.
Yeah, McRibs.
And it's not, and it's not meat.
What
no,
is
no.
it, though?
It's just some delicious.
They ought to do a how it's
substitute.
Made. You know that show How It's Made? They ought to do it on the McRib. I'd love to see.
There's got
to
be info on the internet.
Because you know someone's not at McDonald's, wherever they get the food, slicing pork loin, you know, and fucking delicately cooking it. That is a molded piece of liquefied pork product. With packing peanuts mixed into an auger.
And it's a stamp. They're just stamping those things out.
In a tool and
to make it look like a rib.
Like they make car parts.
Yeah.
They're just fucking stamping that shit out, and then they cover it with deliciousness barbecue sauce.
Brett's like, I haven't been at McDonald's since I was 12 years old.
Good to see you again, man, Brett.
I'm a McDonald's French fries guy.
Oh, fries? Yeah.
Yeah, but I love Burger King for breakfast.
For breakfast? Wow, that's can't imagine that
shit. Sandwich.
Wait, Patrice looked at him like, yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, because
I don't even know what that meant.
McDonald's has nothing that competes. Matter of fact, Burger King has a new McMuffin, but they call it the Berg Muffin, and it's delicious.
Berg Muffin, what a ripoff.
Much better done than the
Egg McMuffin. I thought you were eating better.
No, this is from years of bad food, nigga. It's like a junkie knowing the best heroin.
My favorite burger of all of them is Wendy's, I gotta say.
Yeah, the Wendy's burger.
Holy shit.
I know that.
You know what, though?
No onions, though.
You've dealt with black people your fucking half your life.
Yeah.
That's why. Black people, Wendy's.
My whole life.
Wendy's is a good show.
And if you're in a pinch, Burger King is decent.
Do black people like aliens?
Oh, yeah, I think that's
the movie Aliens.
No, just aliens.
Aliens
in general. Do we believe in aliens?
No, do you like movies with aliens in it?
Mm.
You know what? Yes, I would. I don't think that's fringe.
And look how
Skyline.
And look, now we're talking about Skyline.
Oh, you directed Skyline?
I produced it.
You produced Skyline?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The kid he was in the remake of Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
Yes.
But then he fucking, I was nervous about him for a second.
It's not about him, though. It's about the aliens. Though.
It's about the aliens but he's in it. He has a recognizable face.
Yeah. He's the human in it.
The human.
Well, there's a lot of them, right?
A few humans, but the aliens are, there's a lot of aliens.
We were talking about the CGI, man. It looks amazing.
The trailers for this movie are ridiculous.
Looks crazy.
Now, what are these guys doing, these aliens? I'm trying to figure this movie out.
Well, I'll tell you, they're invading the Earth.
They're very angry.
They're pissed off.
Why are you being coy about it? The fuck is it? Top secret? I want to know. What are they doing?
We want people to see the movie.
Yeah. Wait a minute, though. But I'm talking about what you see. You see the guys go, don't look at him in the face. This is shit I already know from the trailer. Don't look at him in the face.
Let me ask you a question. You're driving down the street. There's an accident on the side of the road. Ambulances. Is there one person that's not going to go, oh, my God, look at that over there? Everybody's going to look.
I don't look. I look at the guy in front of me. And if I see brake lights, I get on my horn. I'm like, move, you son of a...
Most people are going to look. So these aliens are out there. They're coming.
Now, may I ask, is it an attack movie or is it a kidnapping movie?
Oh, it's an attack movie.
It's an attack and a kidnapping.
Okay.
Oh, shit.
All right.
Really? And you found Dan Rather, which is weird.
Yeah.
There he is, right there.
Hey, look at that.
Good old Dan Rather doing the news reports for Skyline.
Yeah, it's a great looking. It's giving me that feeling that Independence Day gave me when I saw the trailer.
Except this was done independently. Like, literally, these two guys called the Brothers Strauss. I wish I had the Brothers Ratner so I could put some of the blame on my brother.
Is that Matrix?
No, it's the guys who directed Alien vs. Predator.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Okay?
Oh,
okay.
And they're visual effects gurus. And I met them because they did X-Men The Last Stand for
me. It is ridiculous, the visual effects.
And they did Benjamin Button. They're incredible. And these guys did this all on their computer. Like, literally, they shot this movie, like, in 20-something days with no money. In their own apartment.
Ah.
There were no trailers. I swear to God, this is their building where they live. The whole movie takes place in that building. All of a sudden, they brought out the goods. I mean, these guys, when I saw, you know, they're really good friends.
It is amazing what you
It's mind-blowing.
It is. It looks like a big-budget film.
And it costs nothing.
How much is nothing?
You want the truth?
Yeah.
All in,
$10
million.
Jesus.
The movie looks like it cost $150 million.
Oh, yeah, sure does.
Was
that it, Danny? That's the only thing out?
How excited are you, Brett?
I can't. I'm happy just to be a part of it. You know, I got jealous. I was about to direct Superman years ago.
Right.
J.J. Abrams wrote it for me. He was like my writer. All of a sudden, he's directing Mission Impossible. He's got all these big movies. I'm like, damn, I've been sleeping? I was spoiled with Rush Hour with Chris Tucker. Him and I
were the Brandon Roth Superman you was going to do?
No. Yeah,
I know what you. Yeah, that was supposed to be that one.
And this is all on a computer.
It's unbelievable. These guys, I'm not kidding, are geniuses. I mean, they did Avatar. I mean, visual effects stuff. And these guys are brilliant. And actually, their first movie I think was with Jim Cameron when they were like 19 years old. Mm. They're basically computer geeks, but they're brilliant.
Why not in 3D, sir?
Oh, come on.
3D's taking over the world.
I think the sequel will probably be 3D. We didn't have the money for 3D on this one.
You can tell they're really good with Microsoft Paint.
Yeah.
That seems to be what they use for the visual effects. Okay.
The visual effects are mind-blowing, but it's a great story. It's a character-driven film, and I think it's a movie that you go in there, and I don't think you even... I mean, the story matters, obviously. We're there to watch a story and to care about the characters, but you're going to be blown away watching them. The visual effects are mind-blowing. I mean, literally mind-blowing.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And you feel like it's happening around the world. I mean, these guys are like, and I'm watching the footage as they're shooting, and I'm going, God, you know, not imagining what it's going to be. I know the design and the creature and everything, and then all of a sudden, these guys are visionaries.
Because there's something else going on here. There's the aliens, which is great. You know, the machines, the friggin'
Black Scrubs.
There's something else going. Black Scrubs. Then there's something else going on with the. You know, if you look at this thing, something happens to you.
The thing is, this. I think honestly, what this film's going to do more than anything, whether it's the biggest hit in the world or not, what it's going to do is really change the model. Every studio, every movie studio is going to change their way of making movies because they're not going to say, why do we need to spend $250 million to make an event movie?
Yeah.
These guys, these kids made it for $10 million. And they're, I mean, look at this shit. I mean, it looks like it's a $100 million movie, which blew me away.
Yeah.
I'm just happy to be on the bandwagon.
Yeah, exactly.
You know?
And you know, it's something fucked up happening because the Statue of Liberty's. Panties are showing in. Anytime the Statue of Liberty's fucking draws is.
Yeah, you know there's a problem.
Yeah, she's got a fucking tampon on. Jesus.
Basically, the premise is mass abduction on a global scale. That's what it is. On a global scale, these aliens are coming in. You look into the light, you get sucked into the spaceship. You just look up. And it's calling you. People started by masses are just going out in the street. They're going out in the street. And all of a sudden, you look up, and that shit sucks you up. And it's going to, I'm telling you, it's going to freak people out.
See, I didn't know what to ask. I mean, I don't know what the secret now. Are we food? Are they populating their planets?
Don't tell me.
I don't want to ruin it.
I don't want to know.
I thought that might have ruined it just now.
Listen, the film.
You can kind of see they're sucking people up.
The film deals with the end of the earth, but I'm telling you, they're not just killing you. So that's what's going to freak you out. They're not just killing you.
Is it an hour, 50, 2 hours?
It's 62 minutes. No, I'm fucking with you.
Well, they're going, wait a minute.
You're going to leave the theater wanting more.
Wait a minute. Fuck it. 62.
I like Brad.
You know, the thing is, I make kind of reality-based, you know, kind of action comedies, most of them. And I've done Red Dragon, the prequel to Silence of the Lambs. I've done, you know, Family Man. I did, but most of my stuff is kind of, you know, X-Men, kind of reality. I mean, the truth is, this movie is an alien movie, but you buy it. I mean, that's the thing that's going to scare the shit out of you. That's why we got to get somebody like Dan Rather, you know, somebody that is going to be a voice that's going to say. Yeah, because Steve Hawkins, you know this guy, right?
The guy
He's like, aliens are coming. And there's people in America that really, really believe this.
Yeah.
So I'm telling you.
Jesse the Body.
No, I'm telling you. This isn't a Scientology shit. I mean, people are saying that it's coming. And this movie just kind of is like everyone's fears. Like, what would you do? Basically, this is dealing with, what would you do if aliens came? How would you deal? What would you do? You're in this building.
Rape.
Hide.
I gotta be honest. I get a bunch of guns and just commit a lot of horrible sexual crimes.
Knowing the laws are gonna change drastically by tomorrow.
The law's very, very busy.
Right.
At that point, so I think I get away with it.
You can't just say the aliens are coming. What's their proof? Why are they saying that?
No, I'm just saying scientists, people. I mean, if you look, that report, by the way, that Dan Rather report. And I'm telling you right now, the Dan Rather report was a real report with another journalist that we couldn't license, that we couldn't use, and we went verbatim. The Stephen Hawking thing, about Stephen Hawking saying that the aliens are coming, blah, 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 that is a real report that we recreated. You know, I mean, there's, like, look on the internet. I mean, it's, like, the most talked about shit in the world. I mean, you know, right. And that's why these films, you know, are really working, you know?
I don't believe in aliens at all.
You don't believe in aliens?
No.
I believe.
Well, just like ghosts. I don't believe in things that tease you and they don't do that. Like...
Yeah, like do that.
I believe
shit.
In that. If that happens, I don't believe in peeking around.
Maybe they don't have a reason to do that yet.
Their reasoning, hiding behind clouds, and they're still studying. Well, I don't know. We shit every day and die every day.
Yeah, I don't know if they're hiding.
They're
behind
trying
clouds.
To figure it out. I don't believe it.
I believe there's aliens out there. I'm not sure about the whole UFO
thing. I believe there's a lot. There's life somewhere in the spooga system.
Yeah.
And they don't know us either. They're walking around except for their fucking noses is on their forehead, and they're fucking shopping.
How about this?
At the alien Whole Foods. That's what the fuck they're doing.
And they got the same problems.
Bunch of douchebags.
What if they look like you and me though?
They do. It was probably fuck them. You know what? I bet they probably do look like us.
Yeah.
Because they're going by the same.
The same
rules of the universe.
The same rules of the universe. So it's probably the same shit, except maybe different sun.
Slight variation.
I can believe there's a Krypton. Out there, but Superman will die.
You think there's here? You think there's blacks on other. On other
there's
planets.
Different colors. There's niggas. I don't know if there's blacks.
See, I can't
but
say
there's
that.
A fucking green and orange motherfucker who gets fucked over in fucking.
They're called diggers?
On Slufon 5, nigga.
You're talking about like that. You see, you're talking like they really exist. So you start to believe it.
No, I believe
he
in.
He believes in other life forms, but that's what an alien is.
But I don't believe in that they're here. They didn't build the pyramids. They didn't do nothing special.
Who built the damn pyramids?
Some fucking
Egyptians.
Who built
Yul
the
Brynner.
Pyramids?
Yul Brynner.
He built them.
What about those ancient landing strips?
With the signs?
You don't think they are either?
The lines. What, the lines and shit where they're saying that's
old man with a great lawnmower that's doing fucking.
Not that. I'm talking about the stuff that is carved into the rocks and shit.
Those
right?
things. They're only like a quarter of an inch deep, these things, but they're visible from airplanes.
Why are there landing strips when alien ships can just go
up and down?
Where's that one? Where's that?
So they had a fucking Mayan two flags?
Look, that's an ancient...
Just stop.
Yeah, there's ancient airstrips. Some of them are in Peru.
Yeah, man. Why are they in Peru like
what
that?
How about the sculpture, the faces? What are they called?
The Sphinx or
No.
On Mars?
No.
No.
Easter Island?
Easter Island.
Yeah. The heads on Easter Island.
I believe that people had a lot of time, dude, with sticks and forks, and they carved heads.
They just carved stuff.
How the fuck do they make that?
What fucking? Aliens did that and left them there?
Why not?
Why not? I can believe it, but I don't like all this playing around. That's what I'm saying. I don't like playing around. That's my problem. It's like the aliens are these supernatural things that are watching us and gathering information and abducting us, but they're playing around.
Yeah. Land in Central Park, motherfucker.
Yeah, like stop playing.
Get out, start shooting.
What are you
going to
do
guns?
If they start landing? What the hell?
I'll fucking cry like everybody else is.
You're gonna be a little bitch.
I'm gonna cry exactly. I'm gonna fucking whine and have them fucking, you know.
I like this guy right here.
Hopefully, they want to eat fucking white people.
Look, that's a real alien. The ack alien.
Like these. This is why the kind of movies that you're doing, Skyline
gets in theaters tomorrow.
It's visceral to me, like. Like I said, when I saw Independence Day the first, or that visceral feeling when you see the giant tidal wave that's in every end of the world, that
it's like, ooh,
well, this is the end of the world movie, but
that for those, so I'm
kidnapping people too, so don't be scared if you're sitting in Magic. Is there Magic Johnson Theater in New York? People gonna be screaming
uptown,
at the screen.
Uptown,
run, motherfucker, run!
So you're putting your reputation on this movie there, Brett?
I love the movie. I think it's more it's more than just loving the movie. I really think it's when I love young filmmakers, guys are up and coming that are smarter than me, better than me, going to the next level like JJ did with his movies that he's directing. These two young guys are really young. I mean, to me, I'm an old man now, but these guys are kids. And I did my first movie when I was 26. These guys are probably 30 right now. And they're blowing my mind. It's like they grew up, you know, watching my movies. And I'm now learning from them, which is incredible.
The Virus. SiriusXM. This is the